We're not involving anyone else anymore.
It's a secret.
People must be bored shitless.
Yeah.
Not much of a secret.
Well, we're just... We're very good friends. We're looking after each other.
So it's a game plan.
Yes, it is.
Nice and quiet.
Are they still talking about celebrities?
Guys, I think we should all have quality time and have a laugh.
Why?
Because Jerry and I might be going on Friday. One of us is going on Friday. Right, let's tell some jokes. Right, listen, you lot. I'm listening to my funny jokes. Right, a bloke goes into a bar with an ostrich and a cat drinking. The ostrich is moaning and moaning and going on nagging and moaning. He goes to the ostrich, what do you want to drink then? And the ostrich goes, I'll have a pint. And he goes, no, I'll have a vodka lime soda. Oh, no, I'll have a tea marine coke. And he goes, cat, what do you want? And the cat goes, I'll have a vodka lime soda, but I'm not fucking paying for it.
Hi.
And he goes, all right. So they have those drinks, and then the ostrich starts moaning and going, I'm hungry. Can I have something to eat? And then the bloke's like, okay, fucking hell. What do you want? And the ostrich goes, can I have a packet of crisps? And he goes, no, actually, I'll have some peanuts. Yeah, and the bloke's like, mate, you've mind up, for fuck's sake. And he goes, all right then, okay, I'll have a packet of crisps. And then he goes to the cat, are you hungry? And the cat goes, yeah, I'll have a packet of crisps. I'm not fucking paying for it. And he goes, oh, right, okay, cool. So they eat those. And the ostrich is like, when are we going home? And the cat's like, fuck's sake, will you stop moaning? And he's like, well, the ostrich is like, okay, I want another drink. The cat wants, yeah, I want another drink too, but I'm not fucking paying for it. Charlie, you're going to miss the end of the joke.
No, I know that one.
And then the guy goes, wait, just listen to the joke. And then the guy's like, what are you doing with it?
What?
Charlie, come back.
Charlie, come back. This is the joke.
I know the joke. That's the funny bit about it.
No, but Charlie, tell me
here. Just let me tell the end of the joke.
Charlie, come back.
He's so obvious
what's about. I'm getting something, Nick. I'll be 2 minutes. Go on.
We'll have to wait now, because I want to hear the end of the joke.
What the fuck? Can we hear the end of the joke?
Okay, so the end of the joke.
Yeah.
Where's Charlie? For fuck's sake. Come on.
Here.
So the bloke goes, what the fuck have you come in here with those two for? He goes, oh, well, on the way to the pub, I met this genie, and he goes to me, you've got one wish. And he goes, and what was that then? He goes, a bird with long legs and a tight pussy.
I've heard it before, but told much quicker than
well,
that.
It's funny. Well, damn it. Can you please just laugh at my jokes, please? Because they're hilarious.
Come on, Nikki's joke's hilarious. Everyone listen to Nikki's joke.
What's this?
It's very
dumb. I'm finding this situation uncomfortable. I don't really know what's going on.
Can you just please laugh at my jokes, Nikki? Because they're hilarious.
Are we having fun? Yes.
Can everyone just fucking laugh at my jokes, please? Yeah.
Go on.
Brian, what do you call a deer with no eyes?
No idea.
Okay, that's the best
ever.
What do you call a deer with no eyes and no legs?
Still no idea.
No, right. Please, do I have to sit and listen to
yes,
it?
Yes, you do have to sit and listen to it.
No, it's ages.
Just listen to it. Charlie, just listen to it, because it's really funny.
Listen.
Right,
it's
okay.
It's big color.
Oh, God.
Would Nikki come to the door?
Hi, Nikki.
So funny.
Nikki, you're so funny.
You're so funny.
You love you, Nikki. Yeah. You rock. You rock, Nikki! Holy cow!
How can anybody remember Saved by the Bell?
That's what we were there.
What just happened?
I don't know what the hell
you did. Fucking disaster, Big Brother.
Nikki.
Yeah?
Did you think you were funny?
Yeah, I did, actually. If I was me, I would have thought I was well funny. Just for the sheer fact that, like, it wasn't funny.
Nikki, what do you think the high point of your routine was?
Oh, for fuck's sake. when I was going, can everyone just laugh at me because I'm fucking hilarious? They were like... I did try.
Big Brother thinks you had a tough audience.
Mm-hmm.
Because some of your housemates did laugh, Big Brother is awarding housemates with a special takeaway.
Yes! Come on! Thanks, Big Brother!
What was that all about? I'm quite confused, and I tell you for why. She comes out the diary and she goes, everyone,
no,
I want...
No, she's just being funny.
Oh, she was funny.
She's being
dead
funny.
She's being dead
funny. I'm... really confused.
What? Charlie's in the house!
Still?
Wow, that was clear. Ryan, let's not exaggerate. I've been out there, you know, I've dealt with it.
What? Yeah!
What'd they say, Ziggy? Yeah.
Jerry!
Shh. They said me and you out. Don't,
shut
please,
up.
We saw the signs.
She's out.
Well, she said your name back. What?
This is Big Brother.
Here we go.
Would housemates make their way into the house?
Jeremy, I've been out there, babe. Do you know if that bothers me? Come on now.
It's so funny.
Please. They're still shouting stuff, look.
It's only the second.
Thank you for coming.
Hello.
I have to thank them. They made the effort.
Don't hate it. They're
probably broken. Is that a game
play? Oi!
How exciting was that? Like, be honest, you look, come on. For me to have 50,000 people cheering King Charlie and
yeah, we shouldn't pay any attention from now on because we're going to miss our
I'm a nicer person not to say what I heard, really.
She said, Ziggy, we love
Ziggy. No, she never. She went, get Charlie out, and then she went, something Ziggy, and then she said it again. She said Ziggy's name
again.
We
love Ziggy.
They love Ziggy. Well, I went outside, so, you know, don't tell me what I heard and what I saw because I know what I heard.
Wow. They don't matter, do
no, exactly.
You know,
yeah. Believe me, three people didn't have the biggest fan club out there. So for me to be right about one girl, I've just been out there. I went out there 4 days ago. Didn't bother me.
Yeah,
I had the biggest people with signs saying we love you. And I heard the
it's
worst
okay,
thing
it's okay,
ever.
It's okay, it's okay, it's gone.
If I said it, I'd be being a bitch right
let's,
about now.
Let's forget. Let's say more jokes like Nikki told us.
Didn't she ever get sick of the sound of her own voice? Seriously, she talks so much shit.
Six or nine p.m. Most of the housemates are in the bedroom.
She's like, get out, Charlie, or get Charlie out, yeah? And then she shouts that out, and it sounds like, well, I don't know, put in your own words, something sick, and that's what she said. I didn't hear the rest of it. I went, people are like, ah. I'm thinking they got bigger problems. I heard what I heard when I come through the doors, and people weren't booing me then. She didn't say, she was shouting at something, some divvy ass girl.
I think she shouted out, get Ziggy out.
That's she might not have done those things.
I think that's what it was.
But are we bothered?
That's
some
still the
girl.
No,
some
I don't
people
mind.
Are like, oh, I'm thinking you lot, some people got bigger problems, mate. I heard what I heard, and I'm not talking one person, I'm talking no. fucking
Charlie knows from her fake eviction that she's loved, there's her support. Let's not talk
did
about
it. Did you hear
it
clearly?
Clearly?
I didn't hear it clearly.
No, I
heard
clearly.
My name clearly. And I went, why?
Like, I heard it clearly.
And then she shouted something else out.
Yeah, I know. Well, but anyway, I'm gonna see if I can pull through this one.
Ziggy, cool, don't you stupid, of course you can. It's
she
one
said,
girl.
We love you, Ziggy.
He's completely taken the
we bit. Love you.
It's the, it's the most smallest, momenty thing. I did do something that I maybe shouldn't have done.
Garden's open.
Yes.
We're going to hear it now, or they've either moved the girl on.
We're screaming, we're going, Garden!
Nikki, can you believe it? She went like, I went, Charlie in the house. She went, get Charlie out. Some girl, yeah. I find it hilarious.
I just think it's just, it's annoying me sometimes.
She really has not understood that she was not up for eviction. She
oh,
was
no.
up for a walk
that
and come back. She hasn't realized that. She's illusionary. Like, people love me out there. Well, I hope they do. But impact is the worst kind of thing because you can have an impact. Like, Margaret Thatcher had an impact. Everybody hated her.
The thing with Ziggy, he's quite grown up and mature. He can handle things like that. If it was someone else, they'd be sitting there talking about it all day. Because Brian thought he heard something about him the other day, and he sat there all day going on in my ears when he didn't even say Brian. He didn't say anyone's name. It was some idiot shouting something out, and he thought he said Brian.
Hello, Brian.
Yo, brother.
How are you?
Great. I feel stupid last night, like being upset when I was in Durham, but I think the only reason I was upset is because I thought I put trust in someone I shouldn't really trust in. I felt bad for nominating Jerry. When she was a really nice person. I feel really bad. I don't want Jerry to go. I don't want Nikki or Jay to go. And I feel like I should have nominated Charlie. And then, but at the time, obviously, I thought Charlie was a friend, and she obviously isn't. She's just, I don't know, in one day, not even that, not even 24 hours yet, I've seen a completely disassociated this person. And I don't think we will make up ever. We might be civil to each other in this house, but we won't ever be friends again. Okay, Charlie always had a big ego anyway, even though when I was friends with her, I thought she's a nice girl, she's got an ego and whatever, but her ego since she's come back in this house has just tripled by like a million, quadrillion, billion, thousand times. And it's hard going living with someone who talks about themselves and how loved they are and how hated we all are. And she'll say to you one thing in the 1 minute about how much the people like you on the outside and what she's seen. And next minute, when she doesn't like you, she'll tell you how much everyone hates you because she's been outside and she's seen. And she'll use it for every... I've seen her use it for nearly every single person in this house for how to...